Welcome students, today we are going to talk about collection of data. As we have discussed the meaning of data, sources of data collection, purpose of data collection and the most important instrument of data collection, that is questionnaire, in our previous lecture. In today's session we are going to talk about ways of data collecting. As we all are aware about the meaning of data, that it is a numeric value which helps us in finding solution of so many socio-economic problems. So now we try to find out what are the different ways of collecting data. The first method or the first way is taking personal interviews. The second one is mailing questionnaire and the third is telephonic interview. The first one, personal interview, we are going to discuss this method in full detail. As the name suggests, we are taking interviews of each and every respondent personally. But this method is used when the researcher has access to all the members. The researcher conducts face-to-face interview with the respondents, and the success of this method, however, requires that investigator should be diligent, efficient, impartial and tolerant. Now, after knowing the meaning of personal interview, it can become more clear by taking a real life example. In a recent dental public health study school, children in Cardiff, UK were interviewed about their food choices and preferences. That means what we want to quote here, that each and every student of that particular school was interviewed regarding their food choices and preferences. Now, suitability of this method. The method of personal interview is suitable in the areas in which the investigation size is very limited, because we have to include each and every person. And the second thing is, the greater degree of originality of data is required, only and only this method is suitable, because we are going to take personal interview of each and every respondent individually, or if we want to keep any information in a secret manner, then this method is the most appropriate method, or when accuracy of data is very important and when direct contact with the informants is required. So these are the suitability criteria on the basis of which personal interview of the person can be taken. After knowing the suitability criteria of personal interview method, this method is having certain merits or advantages. The first merit or the advantage is originality. As the name suggests, because we are conducting interview of each and every respondent individually. So whatever information we are gathering from that particular person would be original. Second one is accuracy, because we have a direct contact with the respondent. So that's why information which we have collected or gathered from respondent must be accurate. And the third advantage or the merit is reliability. Because we have conducted the interview of each and every person personally, individually. So whatever information will be provided to us from the respondent will be much more reliable than any other source. The next point is related information. Obviously, if we are conducting personal interview of any individual, we can collect related information also. For example, if we are taking personal interview of any candidate, after knowing the basic details of that particular person, his name, his qualification, his experience, we can also find out his likings, hobbies, etc., which can be used for any other study. The next one is elastic, because the person is having direct contact with the interviewer. If interviewer wants to mold it, or if interviewer wants to adjust that information, it can be done easily. So these are the merits or advantages of personal interview method. Now, again, as a coin is having two sides, this method is also not free from certain demerits or disadvantages. The first demerit or disadvantage of this method is it is difficult to cover wider area because we are taking interview of each and every person separately. So in a wider area, it would become very difficult to take personal interview of each and every individual. Second demerit is personal bias. Obviously, biasness of instructor may affect the interview. If instructor is having some favorable attitude toward respondent, he can mold his results. The third demerit is costly. This method is very costly in terms of time, efforts, as well as money too, because again we have to conduct interview of each and every respondent separately. The last but not the least demerit of this method is limited coverage. This personal interview method is having a very limited coverage because each and every person of the entire population cannot appear for personal interview. So this is the first way of collection of data. The next way of collection of data is mailing questionnaire. After preparing the questionnaire, we can mail that questionnaire to the respondents for collection of data. So when the data in a survey are collected by mail, the questionnaire is sent to each and every individual by mail with a request to complete and return it by a given date. So it can be understood by taking a real life example. For example, there is a hotel in the hill station and the person or the owner of that hotel wants to take feedback of its customer. That's why it is sending questionnaire to its customers and requesting them to fill it and send it back. This method is again having some suitability criteria. This method is more suitable in the area when the area of study is very wide. Why? Because we know that it is easy to send mail the questionnaire to different respondents at different parts of the country as comparison to taking personal interview. Similarly, the method is more suitable in the areas when informants or respondents are educated. Again, this method is having certain advantages or merits. The first advantage of this method is it is economical. Why it is economical? Because we are just making use of mail of sending questionnaire and we are doing a request to the respondent that please fill the questionnaire and give it back to us. Second advantage is it is original. Why is it original? Because the questionnaire is being filled by the respondent himself. And the third advantage is wider coverage. The method is very useful in the areas or the places in which we need to cover so many persons in the small time, like in the previous example of the hotel, because the respondents of that particular hotel may be living in different parts of a particular country. Again, this method is also not free from certain demerits. And the first demerit of this method is lack of interest. Lack of interest is on the part of respondent, because one respondent has received that questionnaire by mail, he may lose his interest in filling that. The second demerit would be it lacks flexibility. Which kind of flexibility we are talking about? Suppose there is a question or there is a statement which is not being understood by the respondent, he will just fill it by his own. And after that, if instructor wants to mold it or convert it, it cannot be converted. So it is a rigid method. The next disadvantage is limited use. Again, this method is useful for only those persons who are educated enough to fill the questionnaire. And the last disadvantage of this particular mailing questionnaire method is the results may be biased, because respondent has just filled the questionnaire and he has sent back his questionnaire to the instructor. Now it depends upon the quality of instructor that he is having certain positive attitude or the negative attitude towards the respondent. So with this, mailing questionnaire is also over. After that, we are going to focus on telephonic interview. As the name suggests, we are taking interview by using telephone. Or in simple words, in a telephonic interview, the investigator asks questions over the telephone. So, it is again divided into two parts or two types. Two types of phones can be used. The first one is traditional telephonic interviews or computer assisted telephonic interviews. Now, it can become more clear by taking a real life example. And the example is, while taking telephonic interview, the main objective is to collect data about the candidate. So, we can ask, what are your strengths or what are your weaknesses? This method is having certain advantages. The first and the most important advantage of this method is, it is less expensive. Why is it so? Because we are just collecting the information by using telephone. Second one, time saving. It saves time, efforts of the instructor because he is collecting all the information, all the relevant data on the telephone itself. And the third and the most important advantage of this method is that sometimes a respondent may feel reluctant in answering a question, and the meanwhile, instructor can assist the interviewee or he can guide the interviewee that you have to give the answer in that direction. Again, this method is having certain demerits or disadvantages too. The first and the most important disadvantage of this method is, many people may not have their own telephones, or telephonic interviews also obstruct visual reactions of the respondents. That means by conducting or by taking a telephonic interview, instructor is not aware about the body movement as well as gestures of the respondent, which are very important in collecting information. After that, we are going to focus on pilot survey. As we have discussed the meaning of pilot survey in our previous lecture too, once the questionnaire is ready, it is advisable to conduct a tryout with a small group, which is known as the pilot survey or pre-testing of the questionnaire. Now, why we are doing it, or what is the need of doing pilot survey? Because it is having certain advantages. The first advantage is, it helps in pre-testing of the questionnaire so as to know the shortcomings as well as drawbacks of the questions. And the second advantage would be, pilot survey also helps us in assessing the suitability of questions, clarity of instructions, performance of enumerator, as well as cost and time in conducting that survey. After that, we are going to talk about main methods of conducting a survey. Basically, we are having two main methods, which are census method and sample survey. A survey which includes every element of the population is known as census or method of complete enumeration. Again, I am explaining this method by taking a simple example. If certain agencies are interested in studying the total population in India, they have to obtain information from all the households in the rural as well as urban areas, their demographic data on birth rate, death rate, literacy, workforce, life expectancy, size and composition of population, etc. These kind of information can be collected as well as published by Registrar General of India, or we can say that the last census of India was held in 2011. So, suitability of census method. This method is suitable on the areas in which the size of the population is very small, because we have to include each and every item available in the population. Or the second criteria of suitability of census method is, when we are having wide diverse items in the population. It can become more clear by taking a simple example. For example, we want to find out or we want to conduct a survey in a small town, in which different persons from different educational background are living. There are the persons who are graduates, there are the persons who are illiterate, or there are the persons who are postgraduates, or in the same town, there are the persons who are researchers or scholars having degree of PhD with themselves. So, we cannot use any other method except census method in that particular town in order to find out educational qualification of that particular area. Similarly, the method is more suitable or desirable when high degree of accuracy as well as reliability is required. Why is it so? Because we know that if we are conducting a survey by taking each and every item in our study, our information would be more accurate as well as reliable. Now, merits of the census method. The first merit of census method is it is reliable and accurate. As discussed right now, because we are including each and every respondent or each and every item in the population, so the information or the data which we are collecting is more reliable and accurate. No doubt, it is less biased. Why is it so? Because we are not doing any kinds of manipulation or any kind of things from instructor point of view. All the information is being collected by taking into account each and every person of the population. Third advantage is it is helpful in getting extensive information. Then the next advantage or the merit is we can study diverse characteristics of the population by using the census method as explained in the last time. That is, if we want to conduct a survey of the educational qualification, then this method is the most appropriate method because we are including each and every diverse item in the population. As said earlier too, each coin is having two sides. Similarly, this method is also not free from certain demerits. The first demerit of this method is it is very costly because we have to include each and every item or each and every person in the population. So, it is costly in terms of time, effort as well as money. Now, the next demerit of this method is large manpower. Because we have to include each and every person, so it cannot be conducted by an instructor or an enumerator only. We need large manpower for conducting this survey. While summing up, we have talked about ways of data collection. We have talked about three simple ways, which were personal interview, mailing questionnaire, and the third one was conducting telephonic interviews. After that, we talked about method of data collection, that was census method. As the name suggests, census method means the method in which each and every item available in the population has to be included while conducting a study. So, in our next lecture, we are going to talk about sample method as well as methods of collecting sample, random sampling as well as non-random sampling. Till then, enjoy reading, enjoy yourself. Thank you.